Good morning, my dear students. In our earlier video, we have started with the poem "You Are Old Father William." In that I have explained you first four stanzas, in which the son asks two questions to Father William, and Father William replies to the questions. Now let us start with the fifth stanza. Let us see what question does the son asks to Father William. "You are old," said the youth, "and your jaws are too weak for anything tougher than suit. Yet you finished the goose with the bones and the beak. Pray, how did you manage to do it?" Now, this stanza also starts with the statement, "You are old, Father William." So here, the son tells his father that you are old and your jaws are also weak. Now, you know, as a person grows old, the jaws become weak. Now, what are jaws? Jaws are the bones on which teeth are fixed. So, when the person grows older, automatically the jaws become weak. So, here the son says to his father that now you are old, and due to your old age, your jaws have become weak. But he is surprised with Father William. Now he says that your jaws are weak as only you can eat the soup. Soot is the hard fat of cattle. So you cannot eat anything tougher than soot. But he is surprised to see his father William eating a goose with its beak and bone. Father William, at this old age, he eats a goose with its beak and bone. So the son is surprised that how could he do it at this age. So he asks his father, how could you manage to do it? How could you manage eating a goose with its beak and bone even at this old age? Now let's see what is the reply given by Father William. "In my youth," said his son, "I took the law and argued each case with my wife. And the muscular strength which it gave to my jaw has lasted the rest of my life." Now, Father William replied to his son that when he was young, as his son is now, so in his youth, when he was young, at that time Father William took a law means practiced law. Now you know that a lawyer has to practice his case in the court, but Father William, he used to practice each and every case with his wife. He used to argue each and every case with his wife at home. "And the muscular strength it gave to my jaws." So the muscular strength it gave. It means what? The practice of arguing with his wife. Whenever he used to argue with his wife, his argument with his wife in his youth gave him the muscular strength. Because of that practice, his jaw became stronger, and that last still in his old age has lasted the rest of my life. Means that strength which he got in his youth has lasted for the rest of his life. And due to that strength, Father William was able to eat a goose with a beak and bowl. He was able to eat the things which were tougher than soot. Now that practice of arguing with his wife at home gave his jaws the strength to eat a goose with beak and bone. Now let's see the next stanza. What is the fourth question asked by son to Father William? "You are old," said the youth. "One would hardly suppose that your eye was as steady as ever, yet you balanced an eel on the end of your nose. What made you so awfully clever?" Now the fourth question also starts by saying that you are old, Father William. Now, as you know, when the person becomes old, his eyesight becomes weak. So here, the young man says to Father William that as you have become old, no doubt your eyes should be weak. Nobody will believe if you tell that your vision is strong. Your eyesight is very good even at this age. Nobody will believe that, because as you're old, your eyesight should be weak. Now, even in this old age, Father William balances an eel. Now, eel is a slippery fish which is like a snake. So what Father William does, he balances that eel at the end of his nose. Now see, to balance a slippery fish which is like a snake, is it easy to balance it at the end of the nose? No, not at all. It is not an easy task. Yet Father William does this easily. So his son, or the young man, is surprised. How could Father William do that? How he is so clever? How he can do all these things? From where he has got such cleverness? So this is the question arose in the mind of young man. So let's see what Father William replies. "I have answered three questions and that's enough," said his father. "Don't give yourself airs. Do you think I can listen all day to such stuff? Be off or I'll kick you downstairs." Now here, Father William refuses to answer the young man. He says that already he has answered three questions and that's enough. Now enough is enough. He doesn't want to answer any more question. Now it is not that he doesn't know the answer, but he thinks that the young man is trying to act over smart. He is trying to prove that he is superior than Father William. And so he refuses to answer the fourth question. Do you think I can listen to all such stuff? So he tells his son that, do you think I will keep on listening all these nonsense questions? I'll keep on answering all these questions? No. Get out. Don't ask me any more questions. And if you don't go out, Father William says that I will kick you downstairs. So Father William says to his son that if you don't stop asking me the questions, if you don't stop acting over smart, if you don't go away from here, I'll kick you downstairs. So that's all in this poem. Now you know that this poem is a dialogue between father and his son. The main theme of this poem is generation gap. You can see in the poem, there is a great generation gap between the old man and the young man, between the father and the son. Here, the son irritates his father by always telling him that you are old. You can see in all the questions, there is a statement, you are old. So he always keeps on irritating his father by saying that you are old. Father William, even though at the old age, he does different kinds of exercise. So what do you think? Is it possible to do exercise suddenly at the old age? No. It needs lot of practice. So it seems that he must have been practicing since his youth all these exercises, and so even at this age he was able to do all these exercises. So through these exercises, Father William tries to teach his son that you have to work hard or you have to practice. Practice makes man perfect. So if you work hard in your youth, you will have the fruits of it in your old age. I hope you have understood the poem, You Are Old, Father William. Now let us discuss the question answers. First question is, why is the young man worried about Father William? The young man is worried about Father William because as he is old and he was standing on his head. The second question is, what are the other three things that amaze the young man? Now the three things which amazes the young man are Father William's ability to somersault. Then next is balance and aim on his nose, and how he finished the goose along with its beak and bones. Next question, how does Father William react to so many questions of his son? Now Father William asks his son not to act over smart, not to put up all those airs, and to be off before he kicked him down the stairs. Let's see, think and answer. Do you think Father William gave his son all the right answers? Why or why not? I think Father William might have given his son all the right answers because he has supportive reasons for all of them. The next question is, was he a patient man? Yes, he was a patient man because he has entertained his son by answering three questions. Next, what makes him a humorous person? His witty way of answering the questions makes him a humorous person. Now let's see, discuss. How do you feel when you see someone in an awkward situation or a tight spot? Will you laugh out but help him or her, or will you taunt him or her? Why? Now if you see somebody in an awkward position, what will you do? Will you laugh? Or will you laugh and help, or will you taunt? Will you give a taunt? See, whenever we see someone in an awkward position, it is obvious that we laugh, right? So if I see my friend in an awkward position, I might laugh out loud. However, I would still help my friend. Now, appreciation of the poem. Identify the lines in the poem which convey humor through vivid visuals. Now, which are the lines in the poem that convey humor? See the last line of first stanza. Do you think at your age it is right? So this line creates humor. Then the second stanza. In my youth, Father William replied to his son, I feared it might injure the brain, but now that I am perfectly sure I have none, why I do it again and again? So these lines also create humor. Then the sixth stanza. In my youth, said his father, I took the law and argued each case with my wife, and the muscular strength which it gave to my jaw has lasted the rest of my life. These lines also create humor. So that's it. Thank you.